A machine that helped develop New Zealand's inaccessible backcountry is celebrating a special birthday.
The faithful old workhorse is the Cessna Skywagon, 70 years old and still going strong. Here's Michael Holland at Ōmaka near Blenheim.
The old girl's turning 70 and her flock has landed. These birds of a Cessna Skywagon feather, the aerial equivalent of the go anywhere, carry anything farm ute.
Kind of like a rough beauty.
Although these days maybe just a little more pampered than they once were.
You're putting your baby to bed.
We put him to bed. It needs to go to bed. It's beautiful.
My favourite position.
Your favourite position?
My favourite position, yeah.
People say if something looks right, it'll fly right, and these just look right.
You dote after it like this every night?
Yep, every night.
The reason for that, sky high dollar signs.
Around about 450,000 for an aircraft like this. I've done a quick estimate with the 80 aircraft here. I think there's probably about 35 million bucks worth of aircraft sitting on the airfield today.
Does your wife know how much it's worth?
If I had a wife, she wouldn't.
Would your former wife like to know what it's worth?
She did. She got half of it.
The first Skywagons rolling off the production line in the States in the early 50s and quickly finding favour in the New Zealand back blocks.
In a matter of hours, this game will be in freezers, ready for the journey to overseas markets.
When it comes to backcountry strips, how remote is remote?
Literally anywhere in New Zealand we can pretty much get into. Riverbeds, tiny little uphill strips and old ag strips.
Rocks, boulders?
Anything, really.
This is Charlie Bravo Sierra. She's in 1962. Did 18,500 hours with Mount Cook ski planes. They called her Charlie Brick Shithouse because she was apparently one of the heavy ones. We didn't think that was really appropriate when we got her, and because this is an old girl, we call her Nana. And yeah, she's lovely, great machine.
A couple of rows over, BJY, the workhorse which played a starring role in this 1963 National Film Unit doco.
Then bigger and heavier cargoes till there seemed no limit to what these small planes could do.
It's also on biscuit tins, jigsaw puzzles, aviation books.
World famous in New Zealand?
World famous in New Zealand, yes, yes. It's been tipped upside down in lakes, it's been tipped upside down on airstrips, and they just keep putting parts in it and keep it going again.
The shining beauty also back from the brink after being written off and now back with its original family from the 70s.
Bring tears to your eyes because it's it was a very special aeroplane to me.
I managed to buy what was left of it for sentimental reasons and we've slowly put it back together.
And when you look at it now, what are you thinking?
It's the best in the world.
Mark Sullivan's a former deputy fire chief turned priest who uses his machine to reach weddings and funerals in isolated areas.
Can't you put a text out and see if someone's got the Rego G-O-D?
Golf Oscar Delta? No, well, actually, my wife is Susan Mary Sullivan.
So you don't really want Golf Oscar Delta?
Probably not that blatant. I like to fly under the radar if I can.